They're punishing
me.
Yeah.
They're punishing me specifically.
They're punishing me.
We have a kind of love-hate relationship, don't we?
More hate than love, but...
We love to hate each other.
We love to hate each other. Well, there's a reason for that.
Yeah, we both specifically asked.
I
love Meg the Bits, but I do
Ian.
Have fun.
I fantasize about Ian.
Why?
In a good way, you know, like I want him to be my friend and...
This is weird. She's got this kind of split personality. Sometimes she's maternal, other times she's very sexual, and then other times, you know, she's kind of...
It's an Oedipal thing, I guess.
It's hard to know where to, yeah, what you're going to get each day. It's exciting. Yeah, yeah, yesterday.
Yesterday.
You said, Meng said before she wanted to answer this one.
Oh, yeah, really?
Yeah, you said, remember you said, let me take all the questions, the hard questions. So.
Okay, you're right, I did. Yeah. I don't know which show you've been interviewing us with, because Ages of Shield, we know nothing. We know the first episode, and that's it. I've been trying to pry some more information out of my writers as far as the direction of where May is going to go. We used to actually have conferences, remember? With our exec. We didn't have it this year.
No, we are going to do one.
We are going
to
do it again?
Next week, yeah.
Oh, but I didn't get the message.
Yeah, but I actually think you do get the message, you just don't listen.
What were we talking about?
I don't know.
Okay.
This is going really well so far, I think.
It was a very devastating season, yeah. I know. I know a lot of people have thought about that or suggested it, which was actually a big surprise for me, because until people started tweeting about it or asking about it, May was so reticent to get back into the field in season one, and even by season three, she had thoughts of leaving S.H.I.E.L.D. to be with Andrew, and it's just that it's the pull with Coulson and the family and, you know, all her little kittens and cubs that she, you know, she's pulled back into being part of the team. So for me, I feel like it's a surprising question that she would take that path. But maybe if she did take that path, it is to leave the responsibilities of, you know, being with this particular family, which can be quite dysfunctional sometimes and heartbreaking, because we keep losing members, and you know, she feels very responsible for it because she always feels like she should be protecting the family, and you know, she didn't succeed each and every time. So I don't know. It's a good question.
No, but no, keep going.
And no.
It's good, no, but that was a good answer, I thought.
Thank you. In the flash forward at the end of the season finale, we didn't get to see this, but we did have Radcliffe mention him. Is that a dynamic that we're going to see more of in the season that you know of?
I don't know, I hope so. It sounded quite plausible that you would, because Radcliffe's almost like he's Scottish, he's got the same kind of, his brain works kind of the same way as Fitz, so he's in the same field, you know, Avenue Field, so you imagine they've got a lot in common.
I thought he was like a New Yorker. I thought your accent.
Not yet. And so, yeah, it sounds they've got the LMDs, the life model decoys, which you talked about. They're definitely going to feature. So, yeah, I would think, you know, there'd be an avenue where Fitz would get involved somehow.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think everyone's, you know, one of people's prime concern is finding Daisy,
finding
right?
Daisy, for sure.
Getting her by. I think everyone's kind of, you know, on that. But also, for whatever reason, it looks like S.H.I.E.L.D.'s changed, so, you know, who knows?
Yeah. I mean, but it's quite obvious that she doesn't want to be found, you know, so I think that's going to be another obstacle.
Because you smothered her, isn't it?
With love.
She smothered her.
Yeah, with a pillow.
Yeah, literally and mentally. Physically and mentally.
I mean, actually, especially for like...
I hope you focus on your girlfriend.
Yeah.
Hello.
Let's not get personal.
Yeah, like, how is that relationship and dynamic going to go forward? I mean, especially with them working together.
With little Fitzsimmons running around the base.
How protective is he going to get to be of her? Or how do you think that dynamic is going to go going forward?
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, let's be honest. They were really like, they were very shy about talking about their feelings and just being on, you know, saying they liked each other. Whereas now, I think they've definitely seen each other naked. You know? They've seen each other's genitals.
I can't believe so you just said that.
So romantic.
I'm, so like rubbed, the dynamics, I'm really rubbing off.
The dynamics. Yeah, I know, actually. It is. It's, I spent all day
with
you and
I'm so
tired.
Good. I know.
Oh, no.
Your genitals.
I mean, it would be a good time to finish. It would be. Not, no. Yeah. Thanks so much.